This is the structure of observer pattern. We'll see how this is implemented in CPP source. This is the class observer. It has subject as data member. It has pure virtual function update. This is the class subject, which has data member observers, vector of observer. It has method attach, which has observer as parameter, and it's pushing into the vector of observer. And this one is the detach. So the attach is for attaching the observer with the subject, and detach is for detaching the observer from the subject. This one is the method notify. So if you will see, it traverses the observer's vector and it calls the update method of all the observer. Here is the set state and get state. The pure virtual function, so will be implemented in the derived class. Here is the concrete subject class derived from the subject. It has data member state. This one is the method set state. In the set state, it's setting the value. And since the state is changing, so it is calling the notify. And notify in turn call the update method of all the observer. And this is the get state. Here the state value is returned. Here is the class concrete observer derived from the observer. It has data member state. In the constructor, it gets subject as parameter and it sets the subject and it attaches the observer to the subject. Here it's passing itself. So you can see the attach method of subject. We have already seen here. So basically this has been pushed to the observer. This one is the update method of concrete observer A. Inside it does the operation which it is supposed to do, and get the state from the subject and it updates its state. Similarly, this one is the concrete observer B. It has data member state. This is the constructor where it sets the subject and it is attached to the subject, and in the update, this is calling the get state of subject to get the state and update its data member state. This is the main. Here concrete subject object is created. Then concrete observer A, where subject concrete subject object is passed. So it sets the concrete subject object in this. Similarly, concrete observer B, here concrete subject obj is called. So you can see when this is called, subject has been, sub data member has been set to the concrete subject, and then it attaches it to the subject. So both the observers has been attached to the subject. Now here it sets the state to 1, so it's calling the set state method of concrete subject. So here it is. In this it sets the value and then it calls the notify method, and notify in turn is calling the update method of all the observers. So it will call the update of concrete observer A, where it will set the value which it gets from the subject. Similarly, in the concrete observer B, it will set the value which it will get from the subject. Okay, we'll run this and we'll see the output. Okay, you can see first for this concrete observer A update stage 1, inside concrete observer B update stage 1. So this one has been shown, and then it updates the value, and then that state has been shown, which is 1. Here we are setting the value 1.